The next speaker is Brigitta Cher from Universitat de València. Please.
Thanks. First of all, I would like the organizing committee for their kind invitation to participate in this seminar on optimization. This talk is based on joint work with José Bermúdez. And let me present the outline of the talk. First, we introduce the portfolio selection and make emphasis in the portfolio selection with faster returns. And then we introduce our proposal for modeling uncertainty for measure the uncertainty of future returns on a given portfolio. We state some properties and equivalences between possibility moments and credibility expected values for LR fuzzy numbers. And then state the multi-objective optimization problem associated with the credibility mean absolute semi-deviation model and present an evolutionary algorithm in order to obtain efficient portfolios and select the best ones using a fuzzy value at risk. Portfolio selection problem deals with how obtain a satisfying portfolio in which the using basic definitions, we consider an assets that compose a portfolio, excite the node amount of asset I held throughout the period, the return RI, the node the relative price change of asset I, and in the classical optimization problem, we consider a stochastic model for the return on each asset with known mean and covariances. Then the overall return on a portfolio is a random variable. Following the mean variance model approach suggested by Markovic in 1952, the choice of portfolio involves a trade-off between the mean of the return and the variance, and the decision variable is a vector of X, that is the components or the amount of asset I in each asset. This is the quadratic programming, the usual quadratic programming. We have the return has been at least equal rho, a certain quantity, and we want to minimize the variance. The basic constraints are for ensuring the investment of total budget and no short positions are assumed. Aside for the approach to selecting an optimal portfolio is also suggested by Markovic, at least this big criterion problem, and the associated escalation problem trades risk against return, and the efficient frontier is traced using assigning different values for lambda. This is the basic models for portfolio selection. And since this formulation, there are a variety of large and improved probabilistic models that have been developed by modifying the risk measures, introducing different measures for measuring the risk, by adding higher probability moments, or critical values are value risk measures, introducing the factors influencing stock prices. And all of these problems are solving or solved using linear or non-linear optimization. Another approach to solve the portfolio selection problem is using fuzzy logic to manage uncertainty. In our approach, we use the we model uncertainty of future returns by using credibility or possibility distributions, which are based on the possibility and necessity of the fuzzy events. And let me introduce some basic definitions and results in order to introduce our proposal. LR fuzzy number is a number whose membership function has the following form. It's a very general definition of fuzzy number. A, capital B define the points with the maximal degree of membership and is the core of the fuzzy number. SI, SB define the spread of the fuzzy number, and the reference functions LRR are epistemic continuous non-increasing functions converging to zero that define the shape of the membership function of the fuzzy number. In our talk, we work with the power family, that is this kind of reference function that includes, of course, linear ones with positive parameters. And in that case, for this kind of reference functions, the support of the membership function is bounded. There are two clear two examples of LR fuzzy numbers. We can see that the concavity and convexity or convexity of the reference function is due to the shape parameter. This second plot, I think, is more interesting because it's a plot that we have built using the returns on a given portfolio and the quantizer of the obtained for a given portfolio allow us to define explicitly the fuzzy number. Sorry. Then our approach, usually, as in the portfolio oscillation, we consider NR-risky assets offering certain returns which are modeled as by means of a fuzzy quantity, and then the total return on the portfolio is a convex-linear combination of the return on individual assets. That is a first approximation to this problem, because it's easier to see that every fuzzy number induces a probability distribution that is defined or coincides with the membership function. But the problem is that if we are consider different fuzzy quantities, that is, with different reference functions or different shape parameters, then the aggregation of this number, that is the total return portfolio, has not the property of being a LR fuzzy number, and then we need to consider the upper level set for every alpha in order to reproduce the membership function of Px. This has some problems at the moment to define or to deal with this this problem in order to obtain the optimal portfolios. In addition, in our opinion, that we are working, I think, more than 10 years in this problem, that is that we see that the propagation of the uncertainty is not, we think that is not well measured if we consider the addition of uncertainty using intervals. And then, moreover, we don't know the joint possibility distribution of the return on the assets. You know probably that in classical portfolio optimization problem, the expected moments of return on assets are known parameters, are completely known, they have been estimated through historical data set, assuming that usually the norm that the vector of return on assets are or is multivariate normally distributed. We have not this kind of information, and then our proposal is don't consider the individual returns on the asset as a data set, that consider the returns on the portfolio as the historical data set. That is, in our approach, we turn the problem around. We assume the portfolio is known, and we directly consider the historical returns on a given portfolio for quantifying the uncertainty of this future return. The uncertainty is modeled using LR fuzzy numbers or the power family, because this family recover a big quantity of usual fuzzy numbers. Then we need to calculate the expected or to use some measures of the expected value and a measure of the investment, and we use this value that is the midpoint of the interval value mean defined by divide Pret using the lower and upper probability mean values of the membership function. And in order to measure the risk on the investment, we use the downside risk value, that is the length of the interval value below mean that is defined using this expression. One particularity of this interval value below mean is that the left point is zero, and then the length of the interval is exactly this upper endpoint. When we are working with a linear reference function that is trapezoidal fuzzy numbers, it's easier, it's well known that the alpha upper, the 0.5 upper level set represents exactly the risk, and the midpoint represent the expected return, but we are working with general error fuzzy numbers. This result is not clear. We are not one alpha cut or upper level set that correspond to the interval value mean, and we need another number. It's the downside risk, the fuzzy downside risk, for obtain this alpha level set. These two moments, two possibility moments, has very nice properties, and there are some results here that the interval value mean that we are using, in fact, as representation of the risk of the investment, is the nearest interval approximation of the fuzzy number. The amplitude of this interval is this interval is the same that amplitude of this interval, and this is the value that we are considering the downside risk, and this is the amplitude of the fuzzy number in the channel sense, and is also two times the ambiguity of fuzzy number. That is from a logic in the logic fuzzy logic, these two values are well considered, and we are using these values in order the constraint and build optimal portfolios. But from the seminal paper by Liu and Li in 2002, there are a very large number of proposals for selecting portfolios using an alternative measure of uncertainty. That is the credibility measure. This measure is the arithmetic mean of possibility and necessity of a fuzzy number, that is based on the always on the membership function of the fuzzy number, but has the nice property of self-duality. What that means at that moment, that using this self-duality measure, it is possible to build or to work with fuzzy variables in the credibility space, like random variables in ensemble spaces. It is possible to construct the credibility distribution that is for a fuzzy variable based on this credibility membership function. And we know that every fuzzy number can be considered as a fuzzy variable, and the credibility distribution is given by this definition. At this point, we think that it will be possible to state the relationship between possibility theory and credibility theory, at least for expected moments. And it's clear. And then we study the expected value of a fuzzy variable stated by Liu and Li. They have another advantage of using credibility distributions, because it allows to build critical values, to determine critical values, that has been the measure for the definition of fuzzy value at risk of a given portfolio, given by Bank and Batala. Our main results. There are no differences, any differences, between for LR type fuzzy variables, not only power, for all LR type fuzzy variables. If we consider a fuzzy variable and a fuzzy number with the same membership function, that the membership function is the key for defining the uncertainty. We have some data, and we use the data for build the or for measure approximate uncertainty. Then, if we have the same membership function, there are no differences between credibility expected values, not only for the mean, also for all the central moments. And I think this is, in our opinion, is important, because there are a lot of proposals. For instance, all the MV type models for in portfolio selection, mean variance, skewness, and other moments are completely equivalent using a credibility theory or credibility distribution, or using possibility distributions. But it is not the case if we work with absolute expected values. If we work with absolute expected values, that in our case is the downside risk, in particular we are interested in determining a measure of the spread of the credibility distribution around the expected mean, the below mean performances, and then we have that the below mean absolute semi-deviation of a fuzzy variable, when the mean expected value exists, has this expression. This is our measure of downside risk. There are some relations when the expected value is in the core, but when the expected value is outside the core, there are no. I think that the uncertainty is best measured using credibility distribution than using possibility distributions when we are working with absolute expected values. The other advantage is the possibility of measure the, or the uncertainty of the percentage of loss in a given period of time. Then, if we are going to work with absolute deviation as a measure of risk, it is well known that this risk measure was suggested by Kono and Yamasaki. Kono and other authors proposed to use lower partial risk models when the return distribution is neither normal nor symmetric. In that case, Lai suggested to introduce the third central moment, skewness, in order to try to avoid large negative returns. And in fact, the efficiency in the stochastic using probability distributions, the mean lower absolute semi-deviation model is more efficient because Ogrisak, I don't know the pronunciation, I'm sorry, Ogrisak and Rusinski prove in a paper in mathematical programming that these models provide stochastic dominance in order to generate the corresponding Pareto frontier. And then in our case, we propose to select efficient portfolios using this B-objective optimization problem. Usually we try to maximize the expected return of the fuzzy variable which associated with a given portfolio and whose parameters are estimated on the basis of the historical data for this portfolio, minimizing the below mean absolute semi-deviation, and we include as also as a constraint the skewness in order to avoid large negative returns. And let me explain the other constraints. The upper bound is included in order to ensure diversification. That is, we put a maximum amount of the total fund which can be invested in each asset. We include also a cardinality constraint because usually are preferred portfolios with a given small of number of assets. The only problem with when we are using a cardinality constraint is you can work with problems. Programación entera. Interprogramming. But in our approach, for us, it's more interesting to know that this constraint is a quasi-concave function, that is the rank of the diagonal x, is number of positive proportions. And we see that in our feasible region include only the restriction that are referred to the decision variables, and the incorporation of skewness is after our definition of feasible region, because the optimization problem, that optimization algorithm that we proposed. At that point is only how we quantify the uncertainty for each portfolio. We consider that we know the returns on individual assets for a T moments or T times, and then we calculate the return on time for a given portfolio. We see this, we are working with the assumption that we know the portfolio, and as a linear combination of the individual returns, but at each point, at pod time, we calculate the return of the portfolio. For each time, we have all the information. Using this data set and the quantize of this data set, using as empirical distribution, we define or build the membership function of the corresponding portfolio. What's the problem now? The problem is all the constraints in the feasible region are define a subset in the n simplex, where the non-dominated portfolio must be selected. Since the cardinality constraint involves a quasi-concave function of x, we have an NP-hard problem. We know that many feasible portfolio compositions are non-symmetric, and that we include positive skewness as a constraint. And in addition, credibility measures and fuzzy value at risk are defined using quantiles of the return distribution, and they can lead to non-convex problem. Consequently, we apply Messier heuristic procedures in order to determine the efficient frontier of the credibilistic mean absolute semi-deviation problem. In fact, we use a modification of a genetic algorithm previously introduced in for tapestry fuzzy numbers, and with three stages. First, we generate M approximate Pareto frontiers using different initial feasible populations. We build the final non-dominated frontier using an intensification step of the genetic algorithm. For the final Pareto frontier, we evaluate the fuzzy value at risk of each non-dominated portfolio, usually for a 5%, the fuzzy var 5%, and we decide the best portfolio using different upper bounds of this value. In our case, when we speak about feasible portfolios, I referred that they satisfy the diversification and restricted cardinality constraints, and because we need to calculate the credibility expected value for feasible chromosomes or feasible portfolios in order to reject those that doesn't meet the additional constraint. Once the non-dominated solution are determined for the current generation, we apply elitism and mutation operators, very usual in this case, in order to update every generation till the end. The initial feasible populations are randomly generated from the uniform probability distribution on the k-dimensional simplex, that is, using the Dirichlet distribution or with all the parameters fixed at one. Once we have the pop size portfolios, we define the same size of portfolios for any cardinal size, and we evaluate the quality of this chromosome using the fuzzy approximation of the return of the portfolio. First, we reject those that with negative fair moment, and then we have risk and return, and so the individuals in order to build the Pareto frontier. I think we repeat this procedure till 100 generations. The stage 2 and the stage 1 and 2 of this procedure, I think, is nice represented here. We are working with weekly returns on 27 assets from the Spanx ABX 35 from January and the 3 years. And bounds, the upper bounds are 0.3, and we are working with portfolios from between 6 and till 9 assets. And we have, I think, is 100 chromosomes or for in the simplex, and 7, 8, 9 simplexes. And this is the representation of the expected return on risk, the mean absolute semi-deviation for the initial population. This is the first this population is not so big, but we prefer working with little generations. In these 2 minutes, we obtain the solution, and then we apply the intensification step. This is the first Pareto frontier. This is the last in the second stage, and after 10 running 10 times our procedure, stage one, we arrive. We apply these non-dominated portfolios in order to build the final Pareto frontier. This is the representation of the value at risk for the non-dominated portfolios concerned respect to the expected return, and we see that when you are looking for more portfolios with high return, we have also high possibility of risk, and we decide to fix some upper bounds for the fuzzy value at risk, and then obtain in each case the best portfolio with this upper bound. And here we have some proposals, and this is only for compare that when we are going for expected returns with portfolios that with more high expected return, we have also high risk. Or the skewness, the behavior of the skewness is very, very strange usually, and we have also the higher possibility of weekly loss. And in conclusion, concerning our proposals, we consider returns on a given portfolio as the historical data set instead of considering the individual returns on the assets, and then we aggregate an uncertainty directly with the returns that we have obtained from the historical data, no aggregation, the aggregation of uncertainties. We have proved the equivalences and differences between possibilistic moments and credibility moments for the retired fuzzy numbers. We propose to apply a bi-objective evolutionary algorithm for selecting efficient portfolios based on credibility distribution, because we are using the mean absolute semi-deviation model, and this is justified because we have proved that using absolute expected values there are differences between a credibilistic and possibilistic distribution. And finally, we apply a ranking strategy based on fuzzy value at risk in order to propose the best portfolio. Another advantage of this approach that is that since the quality of a portfolio is measured using explicit expected values, it can be used even if you decide use different fuzzy numbers, different reference functions, or something like that. And there are some references, and thank you very much for your attention.